trying to run it up. Ain't no time for games and no debating. Just get my money up. Got niggas that need me. Niggas believe me. They we going up. So showtime, game time. Bitch, I'm showing up. Yeah, what's up?
Do. Thank you for checking in with your boy Carnell NCTV. Go ahead and introduce yourself, y'all.
P.RICH, yo. It's P.RICH, the real P.RICH on Instagram. P.RICH, the artist. P.RICH, the official artist on YouTube. Subscribe to my YouTube channel.
Where you from, P.RICH?
I'm from Zeppelin, North Carolina, the zoo.
The zoo, all right. So where you...
100 block to be exact.
Where you get your name from? P.RICH.
P.RICH, you feel me? My first name, Richard. My middle name, Peterson, you feel me? My nickname is Peter, like my hood nickname. So and shit, it's goddamn, I just threw the P in front of the Rich, like filthy Rich with a P-H, you feel me? That's my initials, P-H, you feel me? So I just stuck with it.
So you
really goddamn street name, but I just stuck with his music name too, and shit stuck.
Yeah, facts. So you grew up in Zeppelin, like you born and raised?
Yeah.
Word up. How is it out there?
I mean, you know, it's coming from a city where you really don't got no opportunity or no advantages because it's like, you know, like say for instance, like even right now to this day, like we got a couple videos, we got like one video man that circles around the whole community we got. Everybody's trying to make music. So it's like, we don't got no major recording studios there. So it's like pretty much, bro, just to have an opportunity to record is a blessing, bro. So like for me to be in this position I am right now, that shit made me a star. I'm a celebrity in my hood just for even doing this, bro. Like people don't make it to do events like this.
Shoot.
Like niggas don't have the opportunity to do this shit out of.
Man, so like, what made you like, man, fuck it, man, I'm about to got them hop on the track and just start rapping, right?
My whole life, like, I grew up in church and shit, you feel me?
Yeah.
So, like, my mama was a minister, my grandma was a piano teacher, a gospel player, you know, in church and shit.
So you grew up around music.
I grew up playing church, piano and shit like that, singing and shit.
So you could play instruments, you know, and stuff like that?
Yeah, I could play the violin, saxophone, keyboard.
Oh, so you talented,
Yeah, so it's like shit, you know, when I got them graduated my lifestyle to where I was living, you feel me? Of course, your music gonna change as well.
Yeah.
So it's like, I was always skilled in music, so I kept the music shit going. So I started getting locked up and shit. You know, you go to the county and shit, you sing and shit, locked up. Niggas like, yo, P.RICH, you hard, got that. You need to push this shit, gang. You gonna turn up. So, you know, I'm locked up pushing it. I pushed my first little mixtape when I was in high school, like 16, 17 type shit. Called P.RICH, I do this shit part 5 on YouTube to this day. Shit really trash, you feel me? But I was finding my way, you feel me? I went to prison my senior year in high school, you feel me? I was 17, came home 21. So goddamn, when I came home and shit, nigga, I had the music, I was pushing it on the yard, like hella niggas like, duh. From my homie Bando Rats and shit from Lewisburg. Niggas from all over, bro. Got that. I was locked up with you shit. Niggas is goddamn popping in Carolina. I be seeing at these events like right now. Niggas goddamn was locked up with me while we beating this shit. You know, motherfuckers use that shit to get through their time they going through, to face
yeah.
You know, get through their struggles they going through. So niggas like, yo, this shit, they used to feel me ministering to them through my music and shit. So when I came home, I started pushing and shit. And you know, I ran into niggas where it was so hard, bro. I'm running niggas using YouTube beats. They didn't really know how to push my shit out there. But I always knew within the music was there and the music was original.
Yeah.
So it was the way I was putting it out. And I'm finally finding my way with this shit.
I mean, do you feel comfortable getting into your case, like telling us what you got locked up for? I mean, if you don't want, you ain't got to. Like, we just wanted to get to know who you are.
It's not really, I ain't gonna get too much into it. But I mean, you know, I used to be a former Jack Boy, though. You know what I mean? But I mean, shit, my name P.RICH, so it speaks for itself, you know what I mean? I always been a get money nigga, and I never had to lose or choose the lifestyle that I chose to be exact, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
But I mean, shit, you know, it's like, you know, I choose the route I chose because I feel like this shit, it wasn't necessarily I was raised that way. I feel I was made that way, you know what I'm saying? And you know, like, regardless what type of background you come from, everybody got a choice of right from wrong. We choose the streets. You know, most of the time, we praise wrong. So nobody got to choose it, but that's what I chose, bro. You know, I choose to speak my story and speak my story through my music.
I feel. Do you got anything we can look forward to? You got any mixtapes, videos dropping? Like something we can look forward to, like you want everybody to know.
Oh yeah, I got a mixtape on the way right now. It's called P.RICH, really different, you feel me?
When that dropping?
That's supposed to drop sometime, so I don't want to put no date on it yet.
All right.
My team told me to keep it disclosed, but you know, sometime the beginning of the new year.
Beginning of the new year, he say he's gonna start 2021 off right. For sure. But look, I've been scrolling through your Instagram and stuff like that, and I seen Zay, what's his name? Zay motherfucking Toby.
We gotta go.
Then got, let's get into that right there, man. Tell me something about Zay Toby hitting you up, yo. Yeah, you working with Zay Toby and stuff like that.
I don't even want to be like most niggas, you know, the goddamn, you know, do all the capping and yes, cloud chase, but.
You ain't cloud chase, I done seen it.
I mean, he's always, you know, I mean, like, you know, at the end of the day, you feel me, one of my bros, shout out my nigga Flex, Tree City Mob, you feel me? Goddamn, you know, he tagged me in a little post. I seen it and shit. I was really bullshit on some other, like, I seen it in the morning. Like, damn, this nigga tagged me and shit was Zaytoven. The nigga hit me up, like, yo, you know, you see your goddamn shit, your request, like, all requests and shit, like, not even people you follow. I ain't even following the nigga, you feel me?
Word.
So he probably like, damn, bro, who is this nigga, you feel me?
Yeah.
So I'm like, damn, bro, like, yo, one of the dudes from your city posted and said, you a local artist, is buzzing and shit. What's your budget, you feel me? So the way I look at it, you know, most people, they pray for opportunities like that, but when they come, they don't be ready to accept. And so I just jumped. I ain't even think no hesitation. I just was ready to work with whatever. I told him I would sacrifice everything I can besides quitting my job. I'd give it all.
Oh, so you work a full-time job also?
Yeah, I'm a barber, bro. I part own the barbershop in Zeller, North Carolina.
So, tell me, how long you been doing that?
Yeah, I mean, I'm born in my pops, you feel me? My granddad started a shop in my city in 1947, you feel me? And my pops took it over. I'm the third generation. I grew up around it my whole life. When I went to prison, I started cutting hair on the yard or whatever. You know, I've been messing myself, my homeboys up for years.
Yeah.
So I started taking it serious. And, you know, like, I just noticed I was hustling battles. A lot of people, you know, they go to prison and they try to get out. And a lot of guys hustle to go legit. But I realized I was legit the whole time. I just had to find my niche.
Yeah, find your talent and stuff like that.
I stuck with it, bro. And this is what made this music shit possible.
How long you do on the yard?
Shit, like, 3.5, like pushing 4. I did time in the county too, you feel me? So shit, like I said, I was 11 senior year. I was 17, going on 18, I came on 21.
So did you experience a lot of fake stuff and real shit outside of the outside world? You know what I'm saying?
Instead, as far as like in prison, what?
Yeah, like, yeah.
On outside, oh, yeah. Most definitely.
Like,
I mean, you know the way it go, I mean, like, old heads always told me, you feel me? Like, it's the same thing I'm saying. Out of sight is out of mind, you feel me?
Yeah.
That's a true fact, you feel me? Just because, I mean, you know, that don't change the fact that the people that you love is on your mind, but if you out of sight, you off their mind, you feel me?
Yeah.
And they may think of you, you feel me? But I mean, shit, you know, at the end of the day, bro, when you outside of the world, bro, when you're not in the world, so much stuff go on, you feel me? You're in your own world, you mean, is this? I ain't even really miss the outside, bro. I just use my time, dedicate myself to bettering my life, you know, elevating my thought pattern. And becoming and recreating myself to the individual I wanted to be now.
Man, P.RICH, man, I've been kicking it with you for a while, man, working with you and stuff, man. How old are you, man? You got a grown man mentality, man.
I'm 23.
23, word up. I mean, you remind me of Kevin Gates, bro, how the way you talk, yo, and all that, man. You really. What's the word we're looking for? Hey, yeah, intelligent.
So
did you graduate high school? Or?
No, to be exact, like I said, I got locked up, but I got my high school equivalency when I was in prison.
Oh, well, congratulations, man. So, I mean, like, I know I came late, though, to your show. I had to do a little few runs and stuff. Yeah, but tell me about that, man. How was that experience for you, man?
Bro, I mean, like, the way I go in, you know, it's a cash prize, $1,000, you know what I mean? But, I mean, shit, I came in loaded this bitch already. But, I mean, you know, I definitely came. I just had my mindset, you know, I pray to God, bro. You know, I came, stepped out confident, stepped out with faith. And, you know, I just came with the intention of networking with all artists and getting my name out there. And if I was to win the event, you know, that's good. But if not good, I still got to showcase my talent to everybody know who P.RICH is. And I put on for my city.
But man, you working with major artists or anything like that right now? Like,
matter of fact, you know, I don't know if you're familiar with the homie The Shooter, though. From Tree City, from Knightdale, North Carolina. The Shooter, he has made a hit song called Light Lito. You know, the representing in memorial of Box Carlito, you know what I mean?
Oh, well, yeah.
On my way, you feel me? So, yeah, you know, I just got some stuff on the way with Bo right now. You can look out for that on my mixtape. He definitely buzzing. He doing numbers with that, like Lito.
Man.
Look forward for that. We definitely got something coming on my mixtape. I got a couple other surprising features for you, but, you know, I really just try to make sure I put emphasis on P.RICH on this, you know what I mean? This is pretty much my first debut. I dropped my last mixtape, and I felt one unnoticed, you know what I mean? But I didn't put enough energy and put enough effort into it. But,
man, you gotta keep grinding, man.
I put my effort into it this time for y'all to feel every last minute of P.RICH in this
bit. But I want to thank you for taking the time for the little interview right here, man. Letting the fans and everybody know who you are.
Sure,
man, for this last closing, do you want to tell us anything? Like, look forward to mixtape?
Look forward to this mixtape. P.RICH, really different. I call it really different because I'm a really different individual. Music on a whole different level. Intelligence on a whole different level. Background from a whole different level. I'm a whole different way. I'm not trying to ride today. I'm creating my own way. I'm P.RICH. It ain't nothing that I sound like nobody else. It's authentic. It's original. You can't copy it. So you got to tune in. You want to get it. It's here for you.
Already.